When editing videos, you might encounter choppy preview playback due to limited computer performance or large file sizes. In this video, we'll show you four ways to help reduce preview lag in PowerDirector. First, you can lower the preview quality in the settings to reduce the strain on your computer and improve playback smoothness. Click the third icon at the bottom right corner of the preview window, then select Preview Quality to adjust the resolution. The lower the resolution, the less processing power is required, resulting in smoother playback. The second method is to switch from real-time preview to non-real-time preview in the same menu. By default, playback is set to real-time preview, which plays the video at normal speed with audio. However, if your computer isn't powerful enough, this may result in laggy playback. Switching to non-real-time preview mutes the audio and plays at a slower speed, reducing the load on your computer. This ensures each frame is displayed clearly, which is especially helpful when checking effects or other visual details. The previous two methods reduce your computer's processing load by lowering preview quality or slowing down playback speed, helping achieve smoother performance. However, if you want to preview your video at a higher resolution and in real-time speed, you can try the third method, Preview Render. To start a preview render, click the second button at the bottom right corner. Once the rendering is done, a green line will appear above the timeline to indicate it. Keep in mind that every time you make changes to that clip, you'll need to render the preview again. Unlike the final video export, this feature temporarily generates a preview file in the background to ensure smooth playback during editing. When performing a preview render, the system will start rendering from the current playhead position to the end of the timeline. You can move the playhead to adjust the starting point of the preview render. If you only need to preview a specific section rather than rendering to the very end, you can right-click on the timeline and open the Range Selection tool to manually select the desired section. Setting a specific range helps reduce the amount of processing required and shortens rendering time. The last method is to generate shadow files. If your project includes video files with a higher resolution than full HD, such as 2K or 4K materials, and your computer's performance cannot smoothly play these large files, you can generate smaller shadow files to temporarily replace the original files during editing. These shadow files will lessen the load on your computer's processing. To enable shadow files, click the gear icon at the top right to open the Preferences window, then go to the Performance tab. Check the second option to enable shadow file generation. You can also choose the resolution of the shadow files from the drop-down menu based on your system's performance and the level of lag. Once confirmed, hover over the file name to see the render progress. After it's done, a blue icon will appear at the bottom left corner of the clip, indicating the shadow file is ready. Your clips on the timeline will automatically switch to the lower resolution version for smoother preview playback. Using shadow files does not affect the final output quality. Your exported video can still maintain its original resolution, in this case, 4K.